Right, this is going to be an attempt to repair two very similar Sony Walkman, the WM-10 and the WM-30. I got both of these off of eBay, obviously used. These go back to the early to mid-80s. I believe 83 on this one. I used to have one of these as a teenager. It was my favorite Walkman of all. This one shows signs of life. When you put a battery in it, it will power up. You can hear the motor spinning, but whether or not anything else works on it, we'll see. If you look closely here, it looks like there's a dent. This top portion has been dented. And we're going to attempt to straighten that out a bit. These Walkman were really cool. Let me zoom out a bit, because they're the same size as the case to a cassette. And there's other videos out there on YouTube about these. And I wanted to do this video because there's only a couple about, you know, replacing the belt and getting them to work. And these, what I've done is sort of tried to prep them so that I can kind of show what's going on. This one needs some further repair because it does show signs of life. I have already taken the back off of this, cleaned all of the old belt off of it because it is, it was melted in there. And so I'm expecting to find the same thing with this one. But this little glass window here, or plexiglass window, the glue wore off. And as I was cleaning this thing up, it fell off. So ordered some new adhesive to put on there. But basically the way these work, which is amazing, is you would slide them open and it then becomes just a bit larger than the cassette carry case. And then it opens up so you could put that in. Now, the reason I got tape on here is obviously to keep this glass intact in its place here so I don't lose it, don't break it. But then I also put some tape here to hold the tape type and Dolby switches in place, because they are a bit of a pain to get right as far as the location. So I've taped them so that when I take this apart again, they don't fly out and I don't lose them. So again, on the WM-10, slides open. And as you'll see, this is the battery compartment here. And I really held out to find used units that had clean battery terminals where there was no leaking from the battery, no evidence of leaking. But what's unfortunate with this one, seems like maybe the battery compartment is a little stuck here, but the battery compartment itself is missing, the door of is missing a little tab here that normally be right here that helps slide into this little hole on the side there. And so I'll make an attempt to fix that, maybe glue in a little piece of plastic that's a tab to help make that lock in right there. Anyway, let's get started to take this apart. Okay, so to take these apart, you've got to take a number of screws off. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the WM-30, the black one, because again, I've already done all the work to clean up. And so I'm going to zoom in on this one, set the WM-10 aside. So the screws that you have to remove are these two here. And then there is a series of screws on the bottom of the door. Those have to come off. And then when you extend the door, there are two more screws that are revealed under here. So those all have to come out, and that gives you the ability to pull this apart once you've removed the volume control. So the volume control wheel needs to come off. So we'll go through that. Okay, so to remove this volume wheel, I'm using a nail. I've seen other people use tweezers such as these, and you place them in the hole. these tweezers aren't quite small enough, so I'm using like a little finishing nail here, and I'm just going to stick it in one of the holes, spin this counterclockwise, and we'll break the wheel loose. There it goes. Okay, so once it comes loose, you got to be real careful. Because underneath here, it's a little plastic sleeve that's really important, and it's transparent. So if you don't be careful, you could lose that. So I'm going to keep it with the wheel, and I'll place this in my little magnetic bin where I keep all the screws. Okay, so now to get it apart, I'm using a guitar pick because it's just easier for me to use something that's soft so I don't scratch it. But first thing you do is pull the door. And right here, there's a little hinge that you have to very gently pull free. Oh, you know what? I missed a screw. Shoot. I missed this one. Okay. I thought I had them all. Okay. There. Now this should all come apart. That I have all the screws out. There. So I'm going to set the door aside. We don't need it right now. This is actually attaches to where a cassette will rest on the bottom of this catch here. But anyway, the next part is to use something to kind of pry this away from the backing. And so I'm just using this guitar pick here to do that. Gently, because I don't want to damage anything underneath. Now the hard part is that you got to get the sides here where there are these little switches for the tape type and the Dolby noise reduction. And mine's a little tight because, again, I put tape there to try and keep these little switches from falling. I'll have to remove that tape when I do the final assembly. This is how you pull it up from here gently and get this to come off. Okay, so you can actually see where I taped those switches down so that they don't come flying out. And so I'll have to remove that tape when we're done. Okay, so here is the inside. So let me zoom in. Okay, and as I mentioned, I already took this one apart. It was in bad shape as far as the belt was concerned because the belt had melted all throughout the path along the wheels, the main motor here. And the reason I wanted to make the video is because on some of the other really well done videos out there, there's a couple of them where someone else has shown how to replace the belt on this. What they did was replace a belt that had not melted. And when you have this particular Walkman, you'll notice there's this little guard here where the belt would normally go underneath. And as I was cleaning, I realized that you have to remove this. There's three screws there. You have to remove this because My belt, of course, got stuck and jammed underneath this. And when I removed that, the underside was completely covered with this melted rubber. And that's really bad, obviously, because there'd be no way that you could actually get that off without removing this. So what I did was I removed this. I soaked the whole thing in alcohol. I'll show you. Let me move this out of the way. I basically just used this bottle cap that has alcohol in it. And it was the perfect size because I could submerge that whole guide part in there and soak it and then scrub it to get all of that melted rubber off of there. I cleaned this entire path for the belt, and I got it really as clean as I can get. Now, I can see the staining that has occurred here on some of these other smaller, tiny little gears. Cleaned them the best I could. Doesn't appear to be sticky. Everything seems to spin free like it should. So I think we're in good shape. But anyway, the way that I cleaned these was that I used these tweezers, and I would dip it in a little bit of alcohol, and I would basically just clean the wheel. I saw another tip, which is a great idea, is to get a piece of string, which I don't have any right now, but to get a piece of like cotton string and soak it in alcohol, and then you could wrap it around and, you know, kind of spin the wheels to clean that way. But the other reason I wanted to do this video is, let me pop a battery into this Walkman right now. When I first got this, the eBay auction said that it the motor spun. But when I tried to play it or tried to just see if there was any signs of life, the motor did not spin. So this is interesting. I noticed this piece of rubber is coming off there. Set that aside because I don't know what that's for, but seems to be some sort of spacer, but I'll put that back. What I wanted to do is focus on one particular area here, because this is where I was able to make things work with a battery in it. You got to make sure the battery is all the way in. Okay, so motor is spinning. Show that right there. Motor is spinning. But it wasn't spinning that well before. And what I had to do is, if you notice, when I push play or fast forward or rewind, right here, there's these tiny little switches, little metal contacts that open and then close. So they're open now. See, that one closed. If I push fast forward, you see them close as well. Rewind, you see them close. So what's happening is that these get oxidized, they get tarnished, and you can't make the Walkman work without that happening. So you have to clean those. So I just used some, I just got some deoxit, put a little bit on the tweezers. I also used an X-Acto, put a little bit on the X-Acto, and just rubbed it in between the contacts of the switches to clean them up. And that seemed to really do the job because it came back to life. One other note, the WM-30 will function just like this if you stick a battery in it. Okay, I haven't put the belt on, but you see the motor spinning. The WM-10, this model, you cannot get this to work by just putting a battery in it. And unfortunately, this model, and this is the other cool thing that it protects you, let me back out. This model, you have to have the headphones plugged in order for it to show power. Okay, this light that indicates power will not come on. Once you plug headphones in, then it works because, you know, that keeps this state, keeps it from being left in your pocket unused so that you don't kill your battery by leaving, you know, something depressed. So that's a cool feature of this one. These also have an auto shut off. So once it senses that the tape is done or fast forward or rewind is completed, it disengages anyway, so you're not wearing your battery down. So I'm going to attempt to put the belt in now, and then we'll see if we can get this thing to work. Okay, so I managed to fish the belt underneath here. Let's see if I can get this onto the motor. The belt is so small, it's hard for me to pick it up by the tweezers. So, don't like doing this, but I'm going to use something with a finer point. There we go. Now I can get at it, I think. Yep. Let's get it onto there. Okay, so now this is the path that it goes. Okay. Okay, so now the belt's in. You can see rewind, fast forward, play. So we've got life back to this Walkman here. So let me try and pop a tape in and let's see if it works. So I'll hold it because there's no door on here. Okay, yeah, turn the volume up with the X-Acto blade, just... Yeah, it's working. Okay. Look at that. This thing is older than my son. But I'm stoked because, again, you know, I used to have the WM-10 as a teenager, and I've got hundreds and hundreds of cassettes, a bunch of stuff that's on cassette that was recorded off the radio, such as concerts. So really, really excited to have working Walkman again. I'll be transferring stuff to digital for archiving, but it's nice to be able to play the tapes again. Okay, so I've got it all back together. You got to really take your time putting this door back together with the hinges and everything. It's a little tricky, but everything seemed to work fine, so it seems to play flawlessly. Up next, I'm going to do the WM-10. We'll take it apart and see how bad it is inside. Okay, so it's the next day, and now we're going to take a look at the WM-10. And the first thing that I was attempting to fix on this was the battery door, because it had broken. And that's the way I got it from the eBay auction, I knew. But what I did was I added a piece here. Let me point with the X-Acto. So there's supposed to be a little tab right here, and I glued a piece of plastic into place there. And I got it from one of these cheap, phony cards that you get in the mail where banks are trying to solicit you for credit cards. And I cut it with the razor blade. Glued it into the slot there, and it is not a rigid piece. It is fairly pliable. It does move. And what that will help me do is be able to have a battery door that will actually stay on, because as you can see inside there, there is a place for that tab to slot in. And that's what was missing on this, so that we have a battery door that does not dislodge. Okay. Now, the next thing is we're going to disassemble this. We're going to try and fix this dent here. And I think I should be able to do that. But I got to be careful not to break or bend anything too far the other way. Another thing I learned on the WM-30 Walkman that I figured out was that in order to get this apart, you only need to remove these two screws here. You keep these intact because these are connected to the hinges on the inside of the door here. And if you take those out, it can be a little bit of a challenge sometimes to get that back in the right way because of this sliding mechanism. So these hinges are kind of a pain to put back if you take all of these screws out. So these screws just hold those hinges in place with the bottom of the chassis here. But you do have to remove this screw and that screw. And on this one, there is another screw here that holds the door here. We don't have to remove those. Those on this side of the door do not need to be removed because we don't really need those to access what we need. So we'll do a teardown and see how bad it is on the inside. I'll be doing a cleanup of this as well. As you can see right here, there is still a little bit of residue left over from the previous owner. When they broke this battery door tab, they just used a piece of tape to keep it in place. So there's that. The other thing that I had contemplated doing was if I remove this, the idea of having a battery in there, which I like to use rechargeable batteries just because I don't want to have, you know, throwing away batteries. The other thing I could do is I could put a tiny piece of Velcro on the inside of the battery door and a tiny piece of Velcro on the battery itself, and that would hold the door in place, because if I use a rechargeable battery, then, you know, it's always the same battery. Or, you know, I have a pair of them that I'd have to charge together. So this one thankfully comes with a ribbon here so that you can easily pull the battery out. And, you know, the battery contacts look immaculate in there, which is great. A lot of times batteries get left in and you're stuck with corrosion. So anyway, we'll give this one a tear down and see what it's looking like as far as the melted belt. Okay, I'm just going to double check here that I don't miss any screws. I don't think so. Okay, next step. Again, I'm getting my little finishing nail. And we have to remove the volume. Okay, so we start by rotating this all the way to zero. It bottoms out counterclockwise. Let's see how tight this is. Not too bad. So, there we go. Center that for you guys. And again, when you pull this off, you got to be really careful because there is a plastic sleeve behind here. Okay, so here we go. We're going to try pulling the door off first. A little wiggle. And this does come off. You know, this design is a little different than the WM-30. The WM-30 had some longer pieces of metal that would protrude into the other part as part of the hinge system. And this one doesn't appear to have such long pieces. See, there's these metal pieces down here that slide in. And on this side as well. As we can see, there's an issue here because there's a dent, as I mentioned. And if you look closely, let me see if I can get it on the camera here, profile, sort of, there's a gap there in the metal. You can see it. Let me point to it. There's a gap in the metal right there. See it? So sometimes the door is a little hard to open. But we're going to try and fix that. And maybe what I should do is try and fix that right now. Okay, so what I've got is these pliers that are angled, and I've wrapped a little bit of electrical tape on there to try and keep them from, dog hair stuck on there, try and keep it from scratching up the finish here. And now what I can do gently is maybe squeeze this part together, but I gotta be careful because that can break. Okay, that seems to have helped some. And we'll continue with the teardown. Yeah, it's starting to move easy. Okay, and as I mentioned, that already happened. You can see they come off so easily, but the switch is inside. So I'm gonna keep it like this. I'm gonna pull up to try and separate. Push down on the stop button, maybe. This is quite tight here. This is where the dent is, so it might be a bit of an issue getting this thing. There it goes. Okay, so now carefully pull it down. And lift it off, so that your switches here stay in place, because you definitely don't want to lose those. I'm going to dump those switches into my bin here so that I don't lose them, because I am going to work on the chassis here. I'm trying to straighten that dent out a bit. But I want to point out immediately what I see is signs of belt melted. So we're probably going to have some cleanup work to do here. And sure enough, we can see the belt has melted away. I'll get in tight as I can on this so you can see that. It's all melted right here. This is the motor. You can see signs here. Check this out. I'll get the tweezers out. You can see here. The belt has melted and it's just goo. So it's going to take some time to clean up. Let's see if we can straighten this out. Again, I'm going to use the same pliers, and I'm just going to try and gently lift up on that corner. And there we go. Straighter than it was, at least. Still has a slight tweak to it, but I can try and bend this back in. Not too bad. Yeah, a little bit more. Try and use the electrical tape as a gentle padding. Okay, I think I may have gone a little too far with it, but. Okay, that looks pretty straight. It's not too bad. It's better than it was. Okay. Okay, so I like to take the cap to large bottle of juice or Gatorade or whatever it is, and fill that with isopropyl alcohol, and that becomes my cleaning agent for the gunk that has melted from the belt. So as you can see here, I'll start on just the lid. This gets everywhere, and you got to clean it off. You got to get rid of it because it will get on everything eventually. And you definitely don't want it on the inner workings because it will get onto the new belt and you don't want that. Okay, so there's the inside of the back panel with all the rubber melted belt cleaned off. Okay, so the first thing you'll notice is that this is the motor here. A lot of the belt has melted here. And as we spin the motor, we can see that there's a lot of stuff underneath this cover here that helps guide the belt and keep it from dislodging from the motor's drive there. So we need to remove this because there's probably going to be a lot of melted belt underneath here. So there's three screws, one here, here, and here. And I've got two of them removed, and I think that third one is loose. It's just kind of, I don't know, it looks like they may have put Loctite on there. So let me see if I can wiggle that loose, and we'll get this off so that we can start the cleaning process. Okay, so it looks like on this model, this ribbon cable has been glued to this cover. So I'm gonna have to try and feed some alcohol underneath there and see if I can get that off. Because we definitely don't want to destroy that ribbon cable, because that would destroy all functions here of the Walkman, and we wouldn't be able to repair it. So gently try and feed some alcohol underneath. Okay, so it looks like I've got that ribbon cable detached. I'm going to go ahead and pull this guy out and see how this ends up looking underneath. And I'm pretty sure it's going to look pretty nasty under there. Yeah. And the worst part is there. So here's what I'm going to do. Got my little plastic lid. This happens to fit right inside there. I'm just going to submerge it in alcohol. I'm using 70% isopropyl rubbing alcohol. Just going to let that sucker soak and let that do its thing. Okay, so let's take a look at that metal cover here. And hopefully by soaking it in alcohol, it'll keep it an easier cleanup than trying to wipe it, because once you start wiping this thing, it just becomes this gooey, gooey mess. And the alcohol helps kind of control that, it seems. So that's not bad. Just kind of clean it while it's submerged in the alcohol. So I'll take Q-tip and wipe it down a little bit more inside the alcohol. That worked out pretty good. As you saw on the back cover, this stuff just smears like crazy. But when you have it submerged in alcohol, it works better to clean it up a little easier. The trick is that this is the only part that you can actually submerge in alcohol, unfortunately. So yeah, that's just how it goes. So let me wipe this gently without trying to smear that. And now the painstaking part of getting the belt from the various gears here. I'd basically just take the tweezers, dip them in alcohol, run along the edge groove where the belt will seat, and just slowly scrape and pick away at the belt residue that's melted there. Okay, so I've got this gear cleaned pretty good, but as you can see, it stains easily. If you get this stuff on your fingertips, it just doesn't come off easy. So what I've done here is I'm using a post-it note to hold the gear as I am using this dull-tipped X-Acto blade. I dip it in alcohol, and then I'm running it on the inside groove of the wheel here. And as you can see, it fits pretty good in there to be able to scrape some of that stuff off. And this prevents me from transferring more of the melted belt on my fingers to the wheel. As you can see here, here's a piece of contiguous belt that I've been able to scrape free from the groove here. It's not easy to do. Again, this requires patience so you don't make any damage to the Walkman or yourself, because yeah, you could stab yourself with this blade. And definitely don't want to do that, because then you'd have blood to clean up. I got lucky. I got a big chunk of it off there, so very good. I just got to do some cleanup work, because I see trace evidence of this belt having melted little places here. Just going to do some cleanup. Okay, I zoomed in here, and there are these switches here. And these switches are engaging your different motor speeds when you press your play, fast forward, and rewind. And I'm going to be cleaning those as well. Again, I'll use some deoxit and get it in between the contacts and make sure that that's clean before we move forward. Okay, I've got extreme zoom in view here. I'm just going to touch. I've got my X-Acto blade with some deoxit on it, and I'm just going to touch in between these contacts here. Make sure that they're functional and clean. Now, you'll see here, because of the light, you really see my fingerprints and stuff. It looks much worse on camera than it does in person. Believe me, it doesn't look as bad, but I've cleaned the heck out of this, and the staining just doesn't come off. It just doesn't seem to want to come off, so I'm just going to give it a few more wipes and see about putting the belt on now. Got some other areas here where could be problematic. Okay, so since I had already removed the cover from the motor, I don't have to fish the belt underneath like I did on the WM-30. Just why bother putting it back and then struggling to fish the belt? What I'm going to do, what I did do, is I put this piece of post-it note here, because the glue on the underside of this ribbon cable kept getting onto the wheel here, so I want to protect that. So I'll remove that before I put everything back together. But let's go ahead and get the belt on, and it should be easier than doing it with that cover on. Okay, so I was just double checking the belt path, which way it goes. It goes over the top here. All right, I say it's time to pop battery in. See if we get some life out of this thing here. Okay, let us go. Oh, and you know what? I forgot. We can't get life out of it unless we have something plugged into the headphone jack. All right, let's try this again. No. Oh, it's trying to spin. All right, I see a problem. I missed. The belt went underneath here. It didn't actually catch. So I'm gonna have to fix that. Okay, so I've got some life here. Got the belt in right, but I've noticed it's a little intermittent. See? And I think, again, it's just due to these switches that have been kind of tarnished. So when I touch the switches together with more force, we get spinning. So I'm just going to work on cleaning these switches a little more. Okay, so did a little more cleaning. There's fast forward. There's play. There's rewind. Now, rewind seems to be giving me the most trouble. Now, if you notice, it engages and then it spins down. But this happened on the WM-30 as well. One of the things I think, aside from the switches, is that because there's no tape in here, the circuit doesn't sense any resistance, and so it spins down. I think that might be some sort of power saving feature. So that, I think, is a combination of the switch and that potential power saving feature. So let's pop the tape and see what happens. Okay, so powering up my powered speaker. And I'm gonna pop a tape in. Gotta extend this here. The tape in like so. Okay, let's go ahead and try fast forward. Oh, battery's just, okay, here we go. Okay, fast forward. Try rewind, see what happens. There you go, and it's not stopping. It just will take some time working the switches back and forth to get everything back to running order. But I think it's pretty amazing that this thing is like 30 years old, or more than 30, almost 40 years old now, because I think I got my original one back in 83, I believe it was. And here comes the big test, playing some music. Oh no. It's trying. Okay. I need to turn the volume up. I've got to stick the X-Acto blade here and turn the volume up. So yeah, seems to be playing. Okay, so one of the tips I can give you on putting this thing back together, again, those switches, your Dolby noise reduction and your tape switches. Let me try and hold these with the tweezers, tell you what you should do. Okay, so these go in to the edge here, and this little notch, let's see if I can point at it. See right here, this little notch needs to face like that so that it's at the top. And they are going to face where the buttons on the Walkman are. It's going to face that way. Now, it's a real pain to you to put these in, so that's how they need to go, is both that direction, like this. Okay? There you go. Now, let me get everything situated, and then we'll show the assembly. Take the other part, and what you're going to want to do is come in like this. And the other thing you want to do on the switches is make sure that they're both all the way to one side. And then you check your switches here. Make sure they're going all to the left as well as they match. Otherwise, this just doesn't work. And then when you're doing this, keep it so that gravity is helping keep those switches down. And you should be able to get it back together. That's how I did the WM-30. Okay, had little struggle getting this together and getting the switches lined up, but I got it. And you'll know when you've got it right, because you've got to feel the switch actually snapping when you get it lined up and everything back together. Okay, so now it's just a matter of screws, volume control, and getting everything with the door back together. Okay, got the door on, attaching the two screws here at the bottom. Okay, make sure everything works. Let me zoom out a bit. Let's see. Gotta hold it right. Yep, slides open, slides closed. Door works. Okay. Cool. All right, I'm gonna pop the battery in and pop the tape in again, and let's see how things go. You pull the chair right out from under. I think this tape is either being eaten or it's just a problematic tape. It got eaten by another Walkman that I was unable to repair, which I didn't get off of eBay. It was one that I had saved. Okay, let's go into rewind. Yeah, see, the switches are still having some issues here, and it's just a matter of just getting the thing playing. So I may need to give it another cleaning, make sure everything's good on it. Okay, here's a wrap up. I actually did get the double adhesive stick tape, really fine line tape that I put behind the glass window here. Got the WM-30 all wrapped up. I did figure out what was going on with the WM-10. The little tab that I glued onto the battery door was protruding too far inside, and it was actually blocking the playhead from fully extending down when you pushed the play button. So I shortened that, cut it a little shorter, and everything works perfect now. All right, thanks for watching. I highly recommend obtaining certain used Walkman, because they actually were built to last, and they far exceed the performance of any brand new tape player, whether you're talking full-size component stereo deck or portable player, because they just don't make very good players. They don't come with Dolby noise reduction. You're lucky if there is any kind of tape selector for, type 1, type 2, or metal. These did not support metal, but other Sony Walkman did. And, these things were not built like a tank, but they were pretty substantial, And the fact that these are almost 40 years old, and they still work. It's a testament to the engineering and the build quality of our equipment from back in the day. Unfortunately, a lot of the stuff made today does not last that long. But yeah, instead of buying something new, you could get a better quality player and get a item that would probably last if you can fix it yourself. Thanks for watching.